Hello everyone, thank you very much for joining again this live event, which is lesson 25 from the Spring Security Fundamentals stream, and we continue our discussion on Mechers methods. We actually discussed today about patterns, and we will also compare the Ant Mechers with the MVC Mechers, and I will tell you about my experience with these kinds of Mechers. This is still a lesson where we discuss the authorization configuration at the endpoint level. Remember that we have classified in the previous lessons the authorization configurations as being done at the endpoint level and at the method level. And we've started with the endpoint level configurations, and we are still at the endpoint level configurations. And once we finish with this, probably starting with the next lesson, we'll discuss about the method authorization configurations. So stay tuned for more discussions on authorization, because it's a long subject and we will still have to deal with a few more lessons on this aspect. Now, for our today's lesson, of course, I will as usual share my screen. So that you can see what I'm doing here, and I will start by creating a very simple project. And again, we just have to create a small controller that contains different paths for the endpoints, and then discuss about how to use the matcher methods and the expressions to refer to specific paths. So let's just create a new project. It's a very simple project. Because we again only focus on authorization, so Spring Initializer, and then this is lesson 25, and yeah, version of Java is not really important for this, but let's keep the latest, which is 14 still. And we have, oops, not the WebSocket, sorry for that. We need the web dependency, Spring Web, and of course Spring Security, because that's what we are discussing. And I'm creating my project, and now very fast, let's create a controller for us. And the controller will contain a few endpoints, and these endpoints, well, they should have some different paths that we can discuss, for us to discuss the path expressions. So let's create the controller here. It's new Java package controller first, and then we'll have the configuration. So demo controller, which will actually be a REST controller. And I will just say public string A. That will be a get mapping to say slash A, and that will return a small letter. And then I will copy this endpoint as is, and I will say A slash B. That will be A B. And then I will copy this endpoint as well, and I will say A slash B slash C, and this will be the ABC. And one more, that will be directly B, and I will call it a B. Okay, and I think these paths are enough for us. So observe that for all my endpoints, for the moment I kept using only one method, which is get. And that's for simplicity of the example, because if I do use post, you know that I have to disable CSRF as well. You've seen that also in the previous lesson. And that today we only discuss path expressions. So I focus on the path of the endpoint and not on the method. It can be any method. But of course, when you apply authorization configurations, you can both refer to the method, the HTTP method, and the path as well. Is the new OAuth Spring Security implementation usable? No, the answer, thank you for the question, by the way, it's not really related to this subject, but I want to answer it. So you might have seen that I have uploaded a video about the new authorization server version 001. Where I also mentioned that it is only the first version and is not something you will use in production already. But please take a look on that video and you will find out, and you will actually see it's a 40 minutes video where you can see how to implement an authorization server with what we have for the moment implemented of the new authorization server. But as long as it's only version major 0, it's not usable for production, and as you will see, it actually doesn't even implement all the features. It actually only implements for the moment a few of them. That's only a basic demonstration of how it will look like. So the answer for you is it's usable just to make a demonstration and an example. It's not complete yet and you cannot use it in production ready applications. But take a look on my other video about that, that I have just uploaded a few days ago. It will basically be more useful for you and you'll find out more about this subject. Thank you very much for the question again. So I was saying that you basically do add authorization configuration on the method, on the HTTP method as well. Okay, let's focus on this project, by the way. So yes, I will answer you this question as well, but it's unrelated. If you will watch my other videos on the OAuth, by the way, this is lesson 25, so you will find on this same stream more videos that are related to the OAuth implementation. So the OAuth, Sphinx Security OAuth project, is deprecated, but the part of it related to the authorization server is still the only thing that you can use. So for the moment, even though it's marked as deprecated, that's the only thing you can use. Besides that, the resource server implementation is also still used, so you will still find it used in a lot of real-world examples. And for that matter, I recommend you to also study and learn the Sphinx Security OAuth project. But you will find plenty of videos already on the OAuth project. So now I will continue focus on this. And please, if it's possible, if you have questions for what I discuss here, it's better not to just split the discussion, especially for the fact that the OAuth subject, I have already dissected it in plenty of videos that you can find them and you can watch them for free on this same channel. So take a look on videos about OAuth on this same channel and you will hear me discussing about the old implementation and the new implementation as well. It's much better than discussing now about it because it's a totally different subject than our today's lesson. But thank you very much for your questions, of course. So let's get on with our authorization configuration. So I said I won't focus on the method, even though you will basically add endpoint configurations for the HTTP method as well. Probably in the next lesson we'll do a mix of them. We'll basically just focus on the path. So let's create a configuration. I say just the config here, and in the config, I'll basically say project config, and I don't want to see that anymore. Okay, basically say configuration, and then of course we need to extend web security configurator adapter. So in the web security configurator adapter, we'll override the configure method. That helps us set up the endpoint configuration, and we also need very fast to define a user details service, not bin, just user details service, everything I want. I don't override anything. Okay, sorry IntelliJ, but that's not what I wanted to do. So user details service, and just take an in-memory user details service for our example. So return user details service, and then user details U1 user with username, say Bill, password 12345, authority read, and that's enough. And just one more, because we'll maybe need a couple of them with different authorities. So this is with a different authority, and add both of these to the user details service, and then the password encoder. And did I add the bin annotation? No, I didn't. So let's add the bin annotation. Cool. Now let's play a little bit. So what I want to do now is actually play a little bit. So here is where I actually use basic HTTP. And now I would like to play a little bit with the authorization configuration. So I say authorize requests. And then of course today's lesson is about MVC and AND matchers. So let's put them there in a comment. We discuss MVC matcher. And we discuss the AND matcher. And maybe you'll be surprised to find out that both of them actually work with AND expressions. So both of them use AND expression, AND path expressions, let's say. So firstly, when somebody starts with using MVC and AND matchers, mainly people don't realize what the difference is. And honestly, I can see why, because both of them, they actually work pretty similar, and you use them in a pretty similar way, because you can basically use the same expressions with either of these. And if you search into the documentation, you'll basically find not really many details about the difference between these, which is actually pretty important, and you will see why maybe in the next lesson, but it doesn't matter. In this stream, you will see that there is a very, very small but important essential difference that you need to take into consideration when using any of these methods. So I will start with my favorite one, which is the MVC matcher, and then I will basically tell you that for all the expressions that we discuss with the MVC matcher, you can actually use AND matcher as well. But because there is a difference between them, of course, even though you can use the same expression, sometimes the same expression might lead to different expectations, to different results. And what we'll do, so after we discuss about the path expressions and how you use them, and you see that they are applicable with either of these, we will discuss about the difference between them. So I will give you an example to show you where the AND matcher works differently from the MVC matcher, and then I will suggest you, and I will advise you to use the MVC matcher. Usually I recommend using the MVC matcher rather than the AND matcher, even though in, again, a lot of cases in real world scenarios, I've seen people using AND matchers just because they don't even know some of them that MVC matcher exists, and then they don't know the differences between them. And because of this, you might even find that you can introduce important vulnerabilities into your application, because as you will see, there are very small situations in which using these matchers might work differently. So again, let's start with what I like the most, and that's the MVC matcher. So I do use an MVC matcher here, and one of the things I can say is I want for path A to have authority, and then I specify an authority for this, let's say is read. That means that only Bill will be able to call this endpoint, and then I can even say, and then any request deny all. So if you took a look on the previous lessons where we discussed already plenty of things about the endpoint authorizations, you know that deny all means that no request is accepted, and then you see at the end you say any request deny all, then it means that everything that's above is applied, and then everything else is denied, which means that in my case, when I say MVC matchers patterns A read, then this one and only this one should be accepted. And because I accept it only for the user that has authority read, it will be accepted only for Bill. That's my expectation. And everything else will be denied. So any of these other endpoints, A, B, A, B, C, and B, won't be accepted at all. with any of the endpoints. So let's start our application and see if it behaves the same as I have described. And I will also start Postman because we'll need it to call the endpoints and to test to make our tests. So both of them are now starting, my application and the Postman app. Okay. Okay, I don't know why Postman takes so long basically to start. It usually doesn't do that, but it seems that that was still a little bit faster than I expected. I've seen there a few minutes. Okay, cool. And I can even close these tasks because I don't need them. I use them in some other demonstrations. And get, and they say HTTP localhost 8080A. And if I call it this way, then I have a 401 because I need authentication. And I go here with authentication. And what I do, I just use bill and 12345. And then I send it and then it displays me an A. Then I try A and B, or A and B and C, or anything else. Well, that basically will drive me to a 4034B than anything I try to do. So that's because the configuration was specifying that any other request is denied. So that's basically what we were expecting, and that's good. So now what I want to show you is that in specific cases, then you have to specify multiple paths which have the same agreement for the authorization. So what does that mean? You might want to say that anything, any path that has a specific prefix like AB and ABC in my case, and let's assume it's a rule where we say anything that's under A, so anything that starts with slash A, needs to have a specific authority, like in my case here. Of course, it's not comfortable to simply enumerate this, neither by calling multiple times the MVC matchers method, which of course creates some few lines of code that can be spared. And of course, you could as well enumerate them with a comma here, like you see that the MVC matchers method actually receives as a parameter varags of patterns, which allows you to specify multiple patterns. But in some cases, you might have plenty of endpoints. First of all, there might be many endpoints that need to be under A. Secondly, in some cases you even have parameters, so you can't actually only just specify them as paths here. So in these cases you cannot simply just specify the path as is, you have to use an expression. And we actually use an expression, a language borrowed from ANT, which is an older tool you might have used in older applications. If you are new in development, you might never see. It actually left a very, even if it's not really that used anymore today, it left this expression, this path expression, that's pretty used in a lot of situations when referring to paths. So you will still encounter this way of working. So in this case, I can say, for example, something like this. And I say slash A slash and then two stars. Then this means that anything that starts with this prefix will apply this rule. So path expression is a regular expression. No, it's not really a regular expression, it's kind of a regular expression, but when I refer to regular expressions, I do actually refer to expressions that are a little bit quite more complicated than can actually be applied to different kind of strings, not only paths. When I say a path expression only refers to a, say, a regular expression only applicable for paths. Like in this case, where these two stars here, they have a meaning only when you refer to a path. And that meaning in our case is that when you say slash a slash star star, this means slash a, but it also means slash a slash b, slash a slash c, slash a slash b slash c slash c, and so on and so forth. So anything, any path starting with an a is according to this path expression. So it's a regular expression, but it's for paths. That's when limited, let's say it's a limited regular expression. It's not for any kind of a string, it's only for paths. Okay, so I hope this answers your question. So now, only by using this path expression here, now I do apply my has authority rule to all the paths that are covered by this expression. So in my case, everything that starts with an A, it's A, AB, and ABC. And the only one that is not covered is this slash B here. So you can see basically that this endpoint, because it doesn't start with a slash A, it's not applicable to the path expression that I have written in my authorization rules. So now I restart the application, and then I will try to test it again. So the same application, the same postman, I'm just trying to test it again and see what happens. So my application started and I'm back, and you see that ABC is now accessible with user bill, AB is accessible as well with user B, A is as well accessible with user B, with user bill, and then if I try B, then it still has a 403, because for B it will run on the any request denial, because B doesn't match on this path expression here. So that's one of the things you need to know. One of the things you need to know about path expressions is the star star operator. And you can actually use this star star operator anytime you want to refer to one or multiple path names. So for example, I could have said just slash A slash star star slash B. And in this case, when it's in the middle, as you can see here, it's in the middle, then this will basically apply to slash A slash anything that's basically zero. I said one or more, but it's zero or more path names. So it can be slash A slash B, or it can be A, B, B, A, B, C, B, C, B, and so on. Because when you use star star, it means zero or more path names. So here you have one path name between A and B. So this one applies the path expression here. Same here. You can see that it starts with an A and it ends with a B. And in between the A and the B, you have more path names. This also applies to star star, because this path expression means starting with zero up to any number of path names in the path. And this way you can basically refer to any kind of path pattern here and apply an authorization rule for that specific pattern. A different expression is using only one star. Like in my case here, I say A star. And when I say something like this, when I use only one star, it basically refers to only one, actually it's zero or one path name. So it will apply to slash A, and it will apply to AB, but it won't apply to ABC because ABC contains two paths after this star. And again, you can use the one star in between as I have been doing here as well. So in my case, I should be able to actually specify different things, like I can keep it like this, and then I can, for example, add another matcher and say for B star, I want a right authority. We have discussed the role versus authority in the previous lesson. So if you take lesson number 24, I remember it was last week, we have precisely discussed the role versus authority subject. I cannot take it again now, but you can find that video recorded for free and you can watch it. And if you have any questions, of course, leave me a comment. You can, I didn't say it, but you have the possibility anytime to leave me comments, and you probably know, and you can find me on LinkedIn and Twitter as well. So role versus authority, it's something we discussed in the previous lesson, and you can find the video recorded about that. So I really cannot just retake the same subject again and again. Sorry, I know you have questions, but you can anytime find these videos recorded on the same channel, and they are free and you can watch them anytime you want. So it's simply impossible for me just to retake the subjects that I have already discussed. Otherwise, we will not be able to move forward. Thank you for understanding. So in this video, I'm continuing with authorities because I'm now blind on this side. I consider you already know it because we discussed it in the previous lesson. So we do only focus here. So that's what you will see me doing now. Focus on the paths. So I want you to understand how to use the path expressions with MVC and AND matchers, and then the difference between MVC and AND matchers. So that's important. And then take from my experience, you can do whatever you want, but I do recommend you use MVC matchers as much as you can if it's possible in your applications. So now if I use it with Bill, it shouldn't work, but this one, it should be useful with John, isn't it? Because John, did I restart the application? So I was expecting that this one is also, but let me check because maybe I'm wrong. So has authority right, and then Bill John. John has authority right. And I took out a little bit the star because I might be wrong with zero in case of one star. Yes. So in case of the one star, it's only one, it's precisely one, it's not zero or one, so my mistake for that. In case of two stars, you have zero or multiple, but in case of a one star, you have a zero or one. So in our case, we can actually say something, but I need one more endpoint here. So A, B, 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 okay, this is the one. And then slash B slash C. Okay, and then B is with John, and I didn't add anything for BC, so this one is forbidden now because it enters on the path with the denial. See, because I didn't specify for it anything, but then I can actually go like this and specify that, say, B star, which will include the BC, then is authenticated. So something like this, authenticated, meaning if you remember, it doesn't need to have a specific authority or role, it just need to have valid credentials. So once it's authenticated, doesn't mean who they are, they can actually access that endpoint. So that's why basically in this case, I should be able to use any of my users to call the BC if I restart now by adding this matcher here. And that's it, and then I send it again, and of course now it works because it will enter on this MVC matcher where the BC expression applies, and then because I have a valid authentication, it will allow me to access the endpoints. So you see, it's pretty easy. We can do one more demonstration to discuss also about path expression. So I will change it to a C here, just to not to separate the example, say a little bit better. And then say I have a C here, and this is a name, which is in my case, as you can see, a path variable. So I can take it as a path variable, string name. And then I say hello name. So what I'm interested in here, of course, is that when you have a path variable, a parameter in the path, you can do as well apply an authorization rule for it. And you can say, a C with the parameter name, and then you can add here whatever on the right, whatever authorization rule you'd like to add. And hopefully with these examples that I have presented you here, now it's a little bit more clear for you how should you use the path expressions. So the most important expressions to be remembered. Okay, let me just test this for you to make sure that it's working. So the last expression that we have used. So the most important path expressions and path expressions that you need to remember, it's using two stars to represent zero or more path names in a path. You can use it fixed, like without any kind of wildcard, without any kind of star or something. It simply applies to that specific path. You can use only one star, that's less encountered, but you can do that if you want to refer to precisely one path name. Or you can simply refer to the parameter as well, if you'd like to refer them to a path that has parameters, and you can refer to the parameter same as you were doing in the case of writing the expression on the endpoint. There is one more that I won't discuss. It's a little bit more complex, and you won't find it very often. Just for you to tell you, you could actually even have a colon here and then a regex, on which you specify precisely how the parameter should look like. It's not really often encountered, but it's a possibility. You can even do that. So if you'd like to say that you apply the rule when and only when the parameter has a specific look defined by a regex, you can write such an expression. You have a colon, and then you specify the regex, and then that authorization rule will actually apply only when the parameter value has that specific shape that is defined by the regex. But again, that's not really often encountered, but you could do that if you really want to do that. So most often are the fixed one, the two stars, and then the parameter, and sometimes maybe you'll find the one star as well. Now maybe you won't be any more surprised if I tell you now, let's simplify a little bit our example. How can I do actually to simplify it? Maybe comment this just to make them sure. So custom authorized page for approval in authorization grant type. I'm not sure what you are asking for. I don't understand if it's a question or something else, but anyway, I can't answer it because of the authorization code grant type is something that we discuss when we discuss OAuth. So let's take that in another video. I'm not sure if that's a question or not. Anyway, going back to our subject here. So we have here only an MVC, and I have only kept the first one just to simplify our example. And what I want to do here is just change it with an ANT matcher. So I'd like to change this with the ANT matcher and restart my application and then test this again and see that's basically working with the ANT matcher. It's working the same. because I said at the very beginning, and again, that's what I why I was saying that you might be not surprised anymore if I tell you now that you can basically use the same. So now slash A, and I think it was Bill, the one with the right authority, and then I send it, and then slash A, slash A, slash B, and so on and so forth. They are working the same as you have seen when discussing the MVC measures. So now, of course, the question is then why are there two different kind of measure methods, and is there a difference between them? And there is the answer is yes, there is an important difference between these two. And to prove you this, I'd like to now comment out entirely and only leave them for your example here, that you will find out later on my GitHub account, and authorize requests. And here's what I will do here. I'm only going to use not any request, sorry, ant matchers, and refer only to the slash A. So I will refer to the slash A, and then I will say you need to be authenticated, and then any other request permit all. So let me say something like this. So any request permit all, then you have authenticated for this. So I'm now restarting the application, and I will try to call this endpoint, which is slash A, and see if I can call it if I'm authenticated, and if I'm not allowed to call it if I'm not authenticated. So I'm not now going here and slash A, I send my credentials, and I can call it without authentication. And then this is again that Postman problem. Let me see if I can actually solve it by creating a new tab. So HTTP localhost 8080 slash A. Yeah, I'm not sure. I think Postman sometimes keeps my credentials, and that's why it's not working. I will try, as I do always, with a C URL. So what I'm doing basically is, in case I'm not able to use Postman, I also try to see if I did something wrong by using C URL. So I'm calling here HTTP localhost 8080A, and you see here I have a 401. So that Postman bug I have presented in some other lessons as well. It's something that's there for many years. So you see, when I do have this problem, I'm actually going to my C URL and try it with C URL directly. So you see, when I try to call the endpoint A without any user, I'm not authenticated. So I will actually try to call it with the user as well. So minus U John 12345. And you can see that this one is a 200 OK, and you can see the body here is very small because it's only the A that I return here, but it's fine. It's what we expected to see. But you again see that indeed when calling slash A here, then I get a 401 without, if I don't provide the proper authentication. Now, if I call this A slash without authentication, then you have the surprise to see that even though I don't have any authentication, if I'm calling slash A slash, so I'm just adding this slash here, then the endpoint has still been called correctly, even though I didn't provide valid credentials. And that's really, really important. That's one of the biggest mistakes I see in real world examples in applying endpoint authorization. Because I've seen so many cases where people use ant matchers. And in case of ant matchers, you really need to be very careful to your expression, because sometimes you might create it might be confusing. Like in my case here, I apply for a fixed slash A. And what I say is that if you have a slash A, then you need to be authenticated. Otherwise, you are permitted even though you don't have credentials. So guess what in this case? Slash A path goes through this rule, but slash A slash path goes through this rule. But for Spring, they are the same thing, which means that in this case, Spring has actually called the same method, and you can test that, you can check that. It's pretty easy. You can simply see it in the answer that when calling slash A and slash A slash, you actually had the same result. So this is a vulnerability in my application now, because I was expecting maybe that path A can be only called if you are authenticated. Would you expect that? Would you expect that path A can only be called if you are authenticated? I would. If I would see this in my application, I would expect I can only call this method here if I have valid credentials. But I have just proved you that you can actually call that method with a simple trick, and that's only because I was unattentive when applying my authorization rules. And see how easy can you create vulnerabilities into your application if you are not attentive. Because in this case, if I'm using countermeasures, I would have actually needed to say explicitly, do apply for these both paths. And if I don't do that, then that's what happens. You think you have applied your authorization rules. You think that only authenticated users can access the endpoint, but guess what? That's not true. And to solve this, the easiest way to actually solve this problem is to, instead of using countermeasures, do use MVC measures. Because the MVC measures are related directly to the way in which Spring understands the paths for the endpoints. So the real problem here, the reason for why you got into this situation, is because applying antmatchers, the antmatchers can basically refer directly to the path pattern that you have specified here. But they don't care about how Spring understands those. So terminal not clear, can you change font? Thank you for telling me, yes. How can I do that? I didn't change the font for a long time in my terminal, but I think it's somewhere from here. So what do you think? Is this better? Thank you for letting me know. So yeah, and I was basically explaining, it's a little bit big, but I think you can at least see it better. So see, when I call it slash A here, I got a 401. I can't see anymore the 401, but it's there. I promise you it was there. Okay. You can see it's an error here. And then I could call it with an user, but then I could still call it only because I had the slash here at the end. And that's really, really bad. So I think still, now what I'm trying to do, I've replaced the end matchers with MVC matchers, and I will rerun the application. And now you actually know how to hack a lot of applications, because you can't imagine how many times I've seen developers using antmatchers and doing things like this without knowing that they deal with this. So now I'm going to show you that when I retry the slash A without authentication, is no longer giving me the body. So it's not no longer working. So only it's now 401, it's what we expected. Mm, Minus V will just make it verbose. I'm not sure if it's more visible, but it will be more verbose in this case. Minus V is the way you make it verbose. If you want to see more details, you can add a minus V here indeed, and you can see a lot of details. Yeah, well, whatever you'd like, it doesn't really matter. Important is for you to see the result. So, very important, when you use ant matchers, like I've done previously, I've proven you that I was able to actually call the endpoint, and this is not the only situation. There are other cases in web applications when you use suffixes and prefixes. I don't go into more details because it's irrelevant. The whole idea is the following. When you use ant matchers take this expression as an ant path expression, and if the path applies to that, they apply the rule. If no, they don't apply the rule. That's why slash a in ant means slash a, and it doesn't mean also the slash a slash. So when I was using ant matchers and I used slash a, it didn't apply to slash a slash as well. But for Spring, both of these are the same. Spring will redirect me from here and from here to the precisely same action, because that's how the handler mapping in Spring MVC works. But ant matchers and ant in general, which only applies the ant path, it doesn't take care about Spring and the way Spring understands the paths. They are totally different one to the other. And that's why if you use ant matchers, you have yourself to take into consideration all the things that Spring might have done. And if you have cases in which different aliases like this, let's call them aliases. I'm not sure if it's the best term, if it's correct, but I think you understand. The important thing is that you understand what I'm saying. You have the responsibility to take into consideration this and find all the possible paths that go to the same action. If you use the MVC matchers, then what the MVC matchers do is that they take an ant expression. That's basically why they look to be the same, but they are not. But the MVC matchers basically refer to precisely the way in which Spring, aka Spring MVC behind, understands the path. And that's why if you use MVC matchers, then this path here goes up here now. And you no longer have a vulnerability, because now you precisely linked all, not only this path, but everything that Spring will identify as being the same to the same authorization rule. And that's extremely important. So it's very easy generally to use paths. It's very easy to apply authorization rules at the endpoint level. In the end, everything is this kind of expression that you have it here as an example now. You just say authorize requests, and then you say ant or MVC matchers. You specify the path. You eventually specify the method if you'd like. You can do that. I maybe didn't tell you, but I think you've seen that in the previous lesson as well. Now I focus on the paths because that was important for the comparison between ant and MVC matchers. But for both of them, for any of them, you can refer to the method, you can refer to the path, or you can refer to a combination of this, which is fine. So you can say you only apply authenticity to get and not to post. It's your problem. But the very important thing is, because here you usually don't make confusions on the method, it's pretty simple. You know precisely if it's a get or a post. It's very difficult to make any confusion here. When you apply a rule, if you apply it to a method, it's very clear usually. When you apply it to a path, however, be very careful what you use. Using MVC matchers, from my point of view, it's easier and clear. It's better because you simply link the route that is also linked by the endpoint itself, which actually helps you avoiding different vulnerabilities that you can make without noticing, because you simply forgot that, or maybe didn't even know that Spring has also other paths that it treats similarly and they lead to the same endpoint. Like in my case here, the slash A and slash A slash, which in this case with the AND matcher, this one was protected, but this one went to the permutal. With the MVC matchers, both of them apply with this same authorization rule. And yeah, it's a very big difference between letting your endpoint available to everyone or making it authenticated. So that's that should be a big thing. So take into consideration wherever you see this in your implementations, in projects, whenever you see an AND matcher, just take a look on the configurations and ask yourself, are they really covering what the developers, what the business rules, and what the security requirements wanted them to cover? Or might it be that there are some leaks out there as the one I have presented you? Because usually using AND matchers, people, developers, don't take into consideration this fact that the Spring doesn't necessarily refer to precisely only one path, and that you might have multiple paths that the MVC handler mapping linked to the same action. And in this case, you obviously have a problem. So this is basically what I wanted to show you today, and I hope to find it useful. It's basically one of my favorites, this one with AND and MVC matchers, because I know a lot of people don't know the difference between these two, and I still continuously find problems in applications regarding this, and sometimes that actually means allowing endpoints unprotected completely, which is not something that you basically want. That's why it's one of my favorites. So I hope you did enjoy it. And what we'll do next, basically, well, we actually have a regex matcher as well, but I'm not that much interested in the regex matcher because it's not very often. I can tell you about its existence, but it's not something that I really carefully really need to take a look over it, because I know it's not often at all encountered in real world scenario. I basically do advise people to avoid using regex matchers because again regex are complex and can create confusion. And one of my rules of thumb is that whenever you want to create something, make it with the simplest solution possible. Choosing to use a complex way of doing that, like a regex matcher, might overcomplicate some things and might create your application over more complex than it should be, and that's called over-engineering. So it really affects the maintainability of your application. So do try to use the simplest way, and I promise you, in 99.99 and even more percent of the cases, applying endpoint authorization with MVC matchers, it's absolutely what you need to do. So that's why I do advise you use MVC matchers if you can, and in most of the cases, that's basically the only thing you'll need. So, because now we've covered, let's say we've dissected completely the way we apply authorization rules at endpoint configurations in with HTTP Basic, in the next lesson, what I will do, I will do an example with this with a resource server in an OAuth system, so that I can cover as well. They work the same, okay? So they pretty it's the same syntax in the same method is the same, but I want you to see it there as well, because I know some of you might see it a little bit different, and then they might say, okay, but the OAuth resource server is different. It's not. You will find out in the next lesson. So that's what I will do. And then the next thing we'll continue with is global method security and method security, because I think we can say we concluded with this subject of authorization at the endpoint level. Yes. So I see. I'm not sure if it's a question or not. What about method security? Is it good to use it? Yes, it is. But that's basically what I was saying. I didn't see your question. Sorry for that. So next lesson, we still discuss on endpoint authorization rules, but we do it on the resource server. And then next one, we go to the global method security. And of course, it's good to use. But as any other feature, you will use it in some specific cases, and we will discuss those. And then regarding postfix as well, yes, of course, I didn't mention explicitly, but I as I've said here, you can actually use it anywhere in the path. So if that wasn't clear, thank you very much for telling me. I wanted to be clear. Yes, it's not necessarily to be the, in general, in most of the cases, as you will see also in the next lessons, you have a prefix and then you will see this as a postfix. But indeed, this operator can be in the middle of the path or it can be at the beginning of the path. So yes, both of them, the one star and the double stars, they anywhere you put them, at the beginning, somewhere inside the whole path or at the end, they do basically the same thing. They represent zero, this one is zero or more path names, and this one is precisely one path name. Okay, so that's basically it. Yes, it can be anywhere in the path, not only at the end as I presented it in the example. It can be anywhere in the path used, and it can be even multiple times used. If you'd like to use it star star slash a slash star star, you can do that as well. So that's also possible, not really often encountered, but possible. So I've chosen here in my example to use the most used, the most encountered situation. But by the means of the ANT expressions, yes, you can use this wherever you want in the path and even multiple times in the same expression. Super, thank you very much. And with this, basically, I think we can conclude also this lesson. And again, hopefully this will be useful for you in the future, and let's meet next week to discuss the resource server and applying authorization rules at the resource server side, which is basically the same thing as you will see. But again, I want to also show you this to be clear for you that you can use the same thing there as well. Thank you very much and have a great time for study further.